27 points. But Derek Fisher, Lakers win the fourth quarter, and they win an ugly one, big game, James, over Philly, and also the Warriors lose. So they pick up a game there, and they are in ninth place now by a game and a half.
Ugly wins are acceptable.
Especially this time of the year.
Yeah, I mean, it was sloppy. And
it wasn't a fun game.
I think we were talking about it. I think D-Fish was talking about it pregame, how the effects of, you know, 3 days off can go either way. And I think the Lakers were really just discombobulated a little bit. The turnovers are indicative of just not being sharp. Mm-hmm. But, you know, we'll take this win. It's a sloppy win. Hey, that's it. We'll take the win.
No Embiid. It's just one of the games the Lakers probably thought they'd kind of flip switch maybe on this one.
No, I don't think so. Yeah. I think they understand the sense of urgency that every game matters. Yeah. It just was one of those weird things at this point in the season to have a game on Monday and not have another game until Friday. It just throws you off just a little bit, just from a timing perspective. You actually get some sleep that you normally don't get when you're playing every other day. And so just your body clocks off, you know, guys, free afternoon without game for a couple of days. Yeah, you get around the golf in, you're running errands, like you actually feel like an everyday person.
Doing the honey-do list?
Yeah, honey-do list. And then all of a sudden, you got Tyrese Maxey coming at you full speed on Friday night.
And it's hard.
It's difficult. So just the turnovers, I think, are indicative of, active Philly defense, but most of the time, guys, it's great. That many turnovers is more mental.
Yeah.
Just not being as sharp as normal.
As James said, not sharp.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, when your offense is not sharp like the Lakers tonight, you got to turn to the defense. And they held Philly to 34% shooting. That'll work. You know, that'll help counteract the 21 turnovers you just pointed out, D-Fish. And this is the first time the Lakers have held a team under 100 since December 7th. So it's been a while since they've put together a defensive effort like this. As you said, Geet, good standings news for the Lakers. They're now a game and a half up on Golden State. They still got to play the Warriors in a couple weeks, but a good win for the Lakers. You know, it's not going to be on the year-end recap on they can stream of all the great Laker highlights, but still take the W. As James said, you'll take any W at this point.
All right, let's go back downtown. AD is with Mike Trudell.
All right, Anthony Davis, just one rebound shy of your third 2020 game of the season, but perhaps you finished this one defending the rim, a couple of blocks on Maxey. What are the keys to plays like that when you're trying to guard your guy but still slide over on that weak side?
Trying to track the ball, just having communication with my guards to, you know, veer back to the big if I go help. You know, he was getting to the lane and making layups because, you know, I was worried about him, you know, dishing it off to Mo. So I told him, you know, that was the final timeout. Well, the under three timeout, then I was gonna just go attack the ball and then the guard just get back to Mo. So that's what I did.
Nick Nurse typically likes to trap you pretty aggressively. Seemed like they did that for much of the night. How do you handle that offensively, and how did you guys try to get out of this rut after being off for the last 3 days?
You said what was the first part?
Just Nurse likes to trap you a lot. Oh, yeah. Seems like, so how do you deal with that?
Yeah, just make plays out of it. You know, we were getting some good looks out of it, open threes, open layups. So just try to pick it apart. You know, anytime they threw it in the post, they came right away on the dribble, I mean on the catch. And I just tried to read it, whether it was weak side or, you know, the guy right in front of me for a three, and then we were just swinging or making the right play. So, and then the time that they didn't, you know, I just wanted to go score and be aggressive. So, just staying with it, not getting frustrated because team taking it away, you know, you got to take it as a good thing. You're good enough where teams are trying to take you out the game in W. So, I tried to use it to our advantage.
We were talking on the broadcast about having 3 days off doesn't happen too often at this point of the season. On the one hand, probably good for your body. Maybe a little bit rusty, though, as a team. Now you get just 12 games left. Obviously, you have to win a lot of them to try to move up. Where do you think the team's focus is at, and what do you have to think about the most?
Yeah, the 3 days, even though it was good for our body, you know, we came out sloppy. A ton of turnovers. I'm not sure how many we had, but
20 plus.
Yeah, that's terrible for us. You know, we're not a team that turned the ball over, and we did that. And that's how, you know, this team stayed in the game. You know, they're one of the best at turning teams over. So we kind of fed into their hands in that category. But, you know, even though, you know, we did that, it was still a good win. You know, I guess a team who's been playing well, you know, even without Joe. So, another one on Sunday and just try to keep it going, especially going to a tough road trip.
All right, man. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Anthony Davis saying hello to some fans. There's D'Lo, his son.
Record-setting D'Lo.
Record-setting D'Lo. Great call, Brez.
Most threes ever in a season for a Laker.
Congratulations to D'Lo. You got Braun and the Brow doing work on Friday. LeBron James only had 9 going into the fourth quarter, but then went for 11 in that final frame to end up with 20. 7 of 15 from the field, 8 rebounds, 6 assists. And then AD, who we will talk about right now, 23 points, 10 of 16, 19 rebounds and 4 blocks, 4 assists. Big game, James. 1 rebound away from his 12th 2020 game. Really messed that up. Almost had it.
We're talking LeBron James, right?
No, sorry, AD.
Okay, AD.
Yeah, AD, 23 and 19.
Yeah, I mean, AD, I mean, he's vital. Agita, we say this over and over. And he figured out in the fourth quarter how to track, some of those guards who were coming in. He got Lowry one time. He got Maxey one time. So, yeah, I mean, AD is a dominant player on both ends. And he continues to show that night in and night out.
Yeah, and the Philly's defense, while like AD did an excellent job of, it didn't negatively impact his efficiency, but it did throw off the overall timing and rhythm of like fluid Lakers offense. The turnovers kind of came from stagnant offensive possessions, ball kind of going to AD, knowing that that crowd was coming, but not as much ball and player movement. So for AD, the 2020 opportunity, phenomenal, almost 12 times to have done that, is incredible. His ability to read the situations is also incredible, not forcing his own offense, which leads to shooting 10 out of 16 from the field. But I think the Lakers continuing to find ways to balance featuring AD without standing around and just feeding him on the block that allows defenses to load up in that way. That's going to lead to hard offense over the course of time.
Yeah, I mean, if Embiid's out here tonight, and he's still a ways away from coming back from meniscus surgery for the Sixers, maybe it's a little more energy. Maybe AD is like, all right, I'm going to have a great, he had a very good game already. Maybe he's in great game mode. Instead, he gets Paul Reed, an undersized big, maybe 6'9", something like that. Very energetic guy, but not a lot of energy on the Laker offense, just enough. I like seeing that. AD's hit a couple threes in the last week or so after going seemingly months without hitting a three. Again, very good game for AD. He helped the Lakers stay above the fray on a night where their offense just was not fantastic.